All right, today we're gonna be taking a look at the Spinnaker Fluess, which is a watch that was sent in by Spinnaker for review. So I'm glad that they gave it to me and I didn't have to buy it, because I'm going to do something during the review that could potentially break the watch. Spinnaker, they include on their dive watches often a leather strap that they claim is water resistant. I wanna test that today. So that's one of the things I'm gonna be doing in this review. But that aside, I've had this watch for a few weeks and I've been wearing a lot, and it's really become one of my favorite everyday watches. In fact, I think it has a lot of things that kind of make it the perfect everyday watch. In particular, there's four things, I think. The first of which is this, the style that it has. I think that, you know, when you're looking for an everyday watch, you want something that is simple, that will go with almost anything you wear, but also has, you know, something distinct and something unique about it. And I think this watch with its kind of vintage styling has that. So we're going to get into that and a couple of other reasons why I really like this watch, and we're also going to really test this thing and see just how waterproof the strap is. So let's go ahead and take a look. All right, as always, let's go ahead and get started with the dimensions and specifications on the Spinnaker Fluess. We have a 43 millimeter diameter, 22 millimeter lugs, 46 millimeter lug to lug, 13 millimeter thickness, and that includes a flat sapphire crystal on the top of it. Inside, we have a Seiko NH35 movement, which on my initial tests has been extremely accurate. The most accurate Seiko NH35 movement I've gotten out of the box so far, running at about plus 3 seconds a day, which is great. And then we have a 150 meter water resistance and a water resistant genuine leather strap. Now again, both of those are kind of odd, so we're gonna talk more about those in the review as we get a little bit further into it. So now I want to go ahead and get into why I think the Spinnaker Fluess is the perfect everyday watch, and I'm gonna give you four reasons for that. All right, so the first reason I think that the Spinnaker Fluess makes the perfect everyday watch is that it has a great vintage style to it. Now, like I said in the intro, I think one of the things that a daily watch needs to have is it should be something that's simple and versatile enough to wear with basically anything that you're wearing, but at the same time have a character that kind of sets it apart a little bit. And the Fluess does that by taking a lot of styling cues from vintage divers. And in particular, it's heavily influenced by, and maybe you could consider it a direct homage of the Blancpain 50 Fathoms, particularly the original ones from the 50s and 60s. Now the 50 Fathoms, if you're not familiar with it, it's kind of the archetypal dive watch. It's one of the, if not the first actual functional dive watch. And the Fluess takes a lot of its styling cues directly from it. You can see in the side-by-side the similarities there, the numerals, the markers, the bezel, so much of it is influenced by the 50 Fathoms. And even that strap is something that I saw on a lot of the different vintage 50 Fathoms that I was looking at. They came on similar leather straps like this. Like many of the 50 Fathoms, the bezel has this kind of bulbous acrylic insert. And it is an acrylic insert on this one, so the insert will scratch over time. You might consider that a patina, something that you might find it will add character to the watch, or that could be a negative. Either way, it being acrylic, it is something that you can buff out, and it stands in, you know, contrast to the crystal itself, which is a sapphire crystal. So the crystal's not going to scratch, but the bezel definitely will. One design choice that Spinnaker did make that they kind of added to this watch, their own little unique touch, was the dial texture. So this has a kind of a very coarse, almost sand-like or gravel-like texture to it. It's very fine though, but it's a very interesting texture, and it kind of, you know, it looks different depending on the different lighting situations. I think it's a nice subtle way to make the watch a little bit more interesting without kind of going too crazy. Again, this being a vintage style dive watch, you kind of want it to stay simple and true to the original, but they did kind of add this on there that kind of gives a little bit of a unique look. So I kind of appreciate that, and it's something that's sort of grown on me more and more as I look at the watch and wear it. Now, while the dial and the bezel are very heavily reminiscent of the 50 Fathoms, I feel like the case has kind of more like a Tudor Black Bay vibe going on with the shape and the longer lugs and the kind of oversized crown. And I think, you know, pulling those two influences together makes for a really great looking watch. I think, you know, it kind of gives you the best of both worlds, because I wasn't the biggest fan of the 50 Fathoms case. It seemed a little bit too roundish to me. So I feel like this is kind of a better case shape for an everyday watch, at least in my opinion. but it comes together really well. And I think it's a very versatile watch that does have a nice style to it, that it's something that you don't see every day, that definitely stands out from modern divers. It doesn't look like, you know, a real tool watch. It has a little bit more of an elegance and a sophistication that you might not see in, you know, kind of more tooly divers. It's also very versatile, and it looks good on a wide variety of straps. And in particular, I really like it on a tropic rubber strap that I picked up. I've been wearing it a lot on that. But you can put it on leather straps. If you have a bracelet, you can put it on a bracelet. It'll look good on that as well. Obviously, on NATO straps, it's right at home. So you got a lot of strap options, I think, with this one, which will give you a lot of, you know, wear out of it. And so overall, I think the style makes for a great everyday watch. It's something that I think you can wear dressed up or dressed down with casual, or if you want to go out on a date, put on with a little bit nicer clothes, and it's going to look right at home in either place. All right, the second reason I think the Spinnaker Fluess makes a perfect everyday watch is because of its durability. If you're going to be wearing a watch every day, you want something that's going to be durable, something that's going to be able to withstand the rigors of daily life, and you're not being afraid to scratch it or bang it or get it wet. So let's go ahead and talk about that 150 water resistance rating first. Now, for a lot of people, you know, having a dive watch that has less than 200 meters of water resistance is kind of a deal breaker. The general consensus seems to be that 200 meters is the minimum that you need to have for an actual dive watch. Now, that said, the Spinnaker Fluess is modeled heavily after the 50 fathoms, and 50 fathoms is a nod to the depth that the original 50 fathoms was capable of diving to, which is actually about 100 meters. So in a sense, this maybe you could make the case that it's not a true modern dive watch, but it's definitely in the vintage dive watch category as far as the water resistance rating. It's definitely as water resistant as some of those original early dive watches. So that's, you know, maybe one kind of cool way to look at it. But from a practical standpoint, 150 meters is basically just as good as 200 meters for everything that you're going to do. Unless you're going to go scuba diving or do professional deep sea diving, this thing's going to handle pretty much everything that you want it to. So if you actually look in the manual for this watch, it basically, you know, Spinnaker, they list, you know, all their watches and what to them the different water resistance ratings means. And according to their manual for this, 150 meters of water resistance is good for all of the same activities that 200 meters water resistance watch is. So in other words, according to Spinnaker, 150 meter water resistance and 200 meter water resistance are both good for everything up to free diving, but not good for scuba diving or professional deep sea diving. And I tend to agree. I think for me, having 150 water resistance rating is absolutely everything I would need. That kind of brings us to the second thing that sort of causes us to scratch our head, and that's that this vintage style diver comes on a leather strap. And now they say that this is a water resistant leather strap, and I wanted to kind of give them the benefit of the doubt there. I'd never heard of a water resistant leather strap. I tried to do a lot of research to try and figure out what that meant. If, you know, is this something that you could actually go swimming with? And I couldn't really find that answer. I did see one of their advertisements. They showed a guy actually jumping in the water with one of their leather straps. So I thought that must mean that they think that it can handle that. So I figured I'd give it a test. So I took the watch and I soaked it. Stuck it in a bucket for about 15 minutes to make sure that the leather was completely soaked through. And then after that I dried it out. And usually it's actually the drying process that causes the leather to be damaged. And so after the watch dried out, I took a look at it, and I was pretty impressed actually. So, you know, initially I thought like maybe it did feel a little bit drier than before. Maybe it had lost a little bit of its softness. But after about 24 hours, it felt like it had gone almost completely back to normal. Now, I do think this will age the watch faster, and I definitely would not recommend, swimming with it on a regular basis. But you know what? If you were out and you had the watch on the leather strap, and for whatever reason, there was a time to go swimming in a pool or the ocean this one time, you know what? I would say go for it. Go ahead and go for the swim with the watch on. It'd probably be okay. Just dry it out good afterwards. And again, as long as that's not what you're regularly doing with it, I don't think it's going to hurt the strap too much, at least not from the initial test that I got. Now, if I was going to be, you know, going surfing with this watch every day, I would definitely put it on a waterproof strap, either get like a tropic rubber strap or a NATO strap or something that you know is going to be waterproof. But again, for the occasional swim, it seems like this water-resistant leather strap will actually hold up. At least, you know, in the one test that I did with it, it seems like it didn't really harm it, that one soak and drying off. So I was kind of impressed with that. Other durable features that this watch has, the bezel feels really solid. There's almost no back play at all, and just a really smooth, really smooth action to it when you're rotating it. It's 120 click unidirectional bezel. Really great feel to it. One of the best that I've felt. Inside, you've got the Seiko NH35 movement. Again, one of the most durable and tried and proven workhorse movements out there, so no problems expected there. And then you're also getting a sapphire crystal, which is, again, great for durability and, you know, keeping the watch face clean for a long, long time. All right, let's move on to the third reason why I think this makes such a great everyday watch, and that's the comfort. So the watch is a very comfortable watch. It's one that, you know, I've worn for, you know, entire days at a time and not had any discomfort with the watch. I think the size for me is the perfect size. 43 millimeter case just wears really well on my 7.5 inch wrist. But part of it, the comfort is that it has these nice curved lugs to it that really kind of hug the wrist well. And I think even if you had a smaller wrist than mine, it would still wear really comfortably. In fact, the entire case, I think, is just really designed really well, and I think they, you know, put some good thought into it. It's a very comfortable case, but then also some very nice finishing. You've got nice brushing along the sides and the top of the lugs, and then feels like a little bit of polishing on the tops of the lugs on the corners of it, which I think gives a little bit more depth. But overall, I think they did a great job on the case, and that wears well. Also, the strap is very comfortable. So it's a very thick padded leather that, again, just feels great on the wrist. It's really soft. It's really flexible and doesn't really have pretty much any break-in time at all. So the strap is very comfortable as well. All right, so the fourth reason I think that this watch is a perfect everyday watch is that it's extremely functional. It has all of the functions that I would hope for in a daily watch. First off, it's got a timing bezel, as most dive watches do, which gives you the ability to time things. So up to 1 hour, you can time pretty much anything you wanted. If you were exercising with the watch, you could use it to time your run. I've used it to time things that I was cooking or doing the laundry, you know, just pretty much anything. It's nice to quickly just use the bezel to rotate it over and then keep track of elapsed time. So very handy feature there. It's also very legible. You have these nice markings all around the edge of the dial that clearly mark the minutes and seconds. In fact, at each of the batons, you have a very small white number that tells you the minute track. So it tells you which minute it's pointing at. There's a very nice contrast going on between the hands and the dial and the individual numbers. So overall, just, you know, really easy to read. You're getting a date window at 3 o'clock, which I know is kind of a controversial design choice, but for me, having a date on a daily wear watch is one of my favorite features. It's one of the things that I use the most. So I definitely appreciate having it there, and I think it adds a lot to the functionality of the watch that they included that. Also, for a daily wear watch, you want something that you can read in the dark. So you want lume, and this has lume. It has a lot of lume. All of the markers are lumed, all three of the hands are lumed, and even the bezel is lumed as well. So it's very functional. You can read it, you know, very clearly at night. And the watch, yeah, the lume, I would say, is decent. It's not amazing. It's, you know, it's not going to blow you away with its brightness or its longevity, but it's definitely functional. You get a good solid lume for, you know, at least an hour with it. After that, in a dark room, it's probably going to start to get a little bit harder to read. But you know what, if your eyes were adjusted, you know, even in the middle of the night, I think it's still got enough of a charge left that you could pick it up and tell what time it was. But that's probably an area that they could have improved on. So again, overall, I think there are four reasons that I think this makes just the perfect everyday watch. And those were that it has a great vintage style, it's extremely durable, it's very comfortable, and it's very functional. That said, it's not a perfect watch. There's definitely some areas that could be improved on. Again, we just talked about the lume. I think that's something that it could have been improved on. It could have been brighter. A lot of people are going to have a problem with 150 meter water resistance. If you're looking, again, for something that you actually want for professional diving or scuba diving, this is definitely not it. Or even if you just want the peace of mind of having a full 200 meter water resistance, you know, this doesn't have that. Same goes for that water-resistant leather strap. That's something I don't mind watches, dive watches, coming on a leather strap, but I always like it if they do that. I think it's better if they included like a NATO strap or a bracelet or a rubber strap or something, you know, an actual waterproof strap, so that you could have that option of saying, you know what, I'm going to use this watch primarily as a beach watch or a swimming watch or a surfing watch, and I want something that's completely waterproof. I feel like they should give you that out of the box. So I think that would have been a nice bonus to at least include like a NATO strap, so that you could, you know, not have to go out and buy something separate if you were going to use this as a watch that you're going to go swimming with all the time. Those negatives aside, I think the watch is definitely well worth the price. Again, it's one of my favorite daily wear watches. It's one that I've really gone to and grabbed a lot, and it's really worked its way into my rotation. So if you're looking for, you know, this kind of watch, if you're looking for sort of a desk diver or a daily wear dive watch, something that can handle pretty much anything that you're normally going to throw at it in normal life, and yet have a good amount of style and versatility to it, I think this is a great option. So I'll put a link to it down below. I think you can pick it up for $285 on Spinnaker's website. I do have I think it's a 15% off discount code, so I'll leave that down in the description as well, so you can check that out. And definitely encourage you guys to go look at it. There are a number of different color options and strap options, even some other different dial options on this one. So if this particular color scheme didn't work for you, definitely go check out the other ones that they've got there on their website. All that said, let's go ahead and wrap up the review, and we'll close it out for today. Thanks again for watching, and we'll see you guys next time.